Hello, welcome to you again in C++ programming. Today we will learn about array. So array in C++ programming, and we will learn about one dimensional array. So before going towards a one dimensional array, we're going to learn about what is array. So array is a sequence of objects of same data type. Means that array can store same data type values. Like if we declare array for integer, it will only store integer. If we declare array for floating type variable, it will only store floating type variable. So the objects of array is called elements. So the thing which is present inside array is called elements. Array is a data structure. So data structure means how data is structured, right? So array is a data structure, which is very, very important note. Data structure is another course that will be delivered to you in the next tutorials, which have a quite a different tutorial series. So just we would view that array is a data structure. An array is represented by index value, means the index value represent the location of the element inside array. So how will array look like? So this card, one dimensional array containing one row and columns, 1, 2, 3, 4, it's containing four columns. We can say that it contain only one row. So only row containing shape is called one dimensional array. So one dimensional array is also known as linear array. Basically consists of one row and one column. So one column, not it consists of this type of arrays called three columns. Well, 1, 2, 3, three columns and one row. Indexing is specify the location of the value present in array. So index will specify the location of this value. So it contains the address. So if it is present in the zero index, so it will specify one. If it is 1, so it will specify 2. So what is indexing? It's clear overview that array is declared. So this is the type of array, type and array name and size. So for example, this is type of array, which is float. This is array name and this is the size. So this array has five sides. So it store five values. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So important note that array will be showing an array is totally depend upon loop. So here we use for loop. So for loop will specify this, and it will assign 0. So array start from 0. So it will show 11 on the 0 index. The value is incremented, and here is 1, it will show 12, similarly 13, 14 and 15. So all the values in array will be shown upon this statement. So let's learn about what is array, how to declare array, how to initialize array. This is called initialization of array. So let's see example which clearing our concept. So this is a simple function in C++. Here the type of array is float, the name of the array is a, and the size of the array is 5, and this is called initialization. We initialize array in different way. So here we use this simple way. So this is for loop. So for loop will showing one by one value like this, then this value will show, then this and this is that. So we will show the output of array by help of, because I is indexing the value, a is the name, I is indexing the value. So this is the way how we can initialize array, declare array, and how to show the output or the data present in the array. So this indexing is really very important. In the next tutorial we will explain these things. So first of all we show about what is the output. So this is the output. This is the output of array. So value of a is 11, value of a is 12, because it is present 0 1 2 3 4. Array start from 0 and the loop will terminate and the value is reach 4. So this is a simple program, and in the next tutorial we will explain about what is two-dimensional array. It is called one-dimensional array, and the next tutorial we will explain about the two-dimensional array.